Hello there guys, it is QWERTEE Afro here. I am bringing you another Fernbus Coach Simulator video. We are on episode 5 and going strong. I'm really liking this series, and if you can't tell, I'm just uploading just mainly Fernbus recently. And I'm really looking forward, and I'm really excited when I like have to go and record some, because I'm really liking this game a lot. I think it's going to be such a good game if TML Studios get it right by standing by it and not just leaving it and forgetting it, because what TML loves to do is they love making games and then just that's it. They just make games, might patch them once or twice, and that's it. They just leave it, they go on to their next project. I hope this will be the game that breaks their kind of habit of that, and this could be like the Euro Truck for them, where they stick by this game. They make other games and whatnot as well, but this game needs to be like, you know, this game needs to be cradled through the years with updates and add-ons and expansions. Who knows, this game could be really lucrative for them in a way of like how Euro Truck and American Truck are working for SCS, as you know, SCS didn't have time to kind of go in and do the European Coach Simulator that they actually originally wanted to do as well. That might be still on the table, who knows. But TML here at the party, and I hope they stay, really, I do. Also, another thing, I hope you've noticed maybe the change of quality with the microphone. I've recently just purchased myself a microphone arm, which I don't know why I haven't done already, because I've just had a normal microphone stand, and which meant mainly in kind of driving videos, I would have my microphone next to the steering wheel, which means that my mouth wasn't right up to the mic, and then the microphone would pick up a lot more noise, and it just would be a little bit more airy in a kind of way. So I've purchased this microphone arm, and now it's like right next to my mouth with the pop filter, which is good. So I hope you can maybe hear a bit of the a bit of my voice clearer, a bit more bassy, you know what I mean. I did try it out on stream, and I listened back to it recently, and it does actually sound pretty much better with the microphone arm and when the microphone's actually right up close. But enough of that, it's just a little technical details there, you know. My setup still is improving and ever improving, you know. Nothing's perfect in my setup or whatever, you know. I have a nice setup and whatnot, but things do still need to be improved. Anyway, before we get into the video, as you probably already know what the title, what we're going to be doing today, the shoutouts in this video go to ComputerFace79 and Luke Maidstone. That's again ComputerFace79 and Luke Maidstone. Their links and stuff will be down below. Please do show them some love. I'm not going to remind you guys about not requesting for shoutouts currently, because I'm trying to go through the current list. And once that list is done, people who haven't had shoutouts can then start requesting again. Right, back on Fernbus. I thought you guys seem to really like the real life routes I'm doing, and the previous route of 009, which we did from Nürnberg to Mannheim, which was really cool. And we stopped off in Heilbronn and Heidelberg. Today we're going to be going again from Mannheim, because as I said, you can only start routes from places that you've been to. So even though I've unlocked pretty much now, I think most of the map. Actually, yeah, pretty much all of the map to go to. I can't start at any of these cities up in the north here. I can only start from places like Mannheim, Heidelberg, Heilbronn, Nürnberg, Regensburg, and Munich. So I thought I'd take actually a suggestion. Someone actually suggested me on stream, I do believe, a recent stream that I did. Someone suggested me a route to do. I've been seeing some people also suggesting me in the comments below off the previous episodes, which is nice. But there was this one suggestion that stood out where someone told me that TML, the people or the studio that actually made Fernbus, actually are situated in Erfurt. And apparently Erfurt's very detailed, of what I've been told. So I'm curious to see Erfurt, because if you know, the previous cities that I went to were kind of like the same, that the layouts and stuff were like the same in Heilbronn and Heidelberg and even in Mannheim, which was a bit upsetting. So I want to kind of go to Erfurt and see if this is the home city of where the developers have, like, you know, made the game. Obviously they're going to take a little bit more care with that city and probably do it a bit more justice than maybe others that they haven't visited that often, because they live and work in Erfurt, so they obviously do Erfurt very detailed. So I went onto flixbus.com, which you should do if you have this game and if you want to do real life routes, and I looked up routes that go from Mannheim, because we just came from we just now finished off in Mannheim, and I looked up if there was any actual bus route that goes to Erfurt, and behold that there was. It is route number 220, and it goes from Mannheim via Heidelberg, so we're going to go to Heidelberg again. Then it goes up north to Darmstadt. Then it goes to Frankfurt Central train station, which I'm guessing that's the one that we're going to go in there. That's the station that's in the city there to go to. And then a long drive to Erfurt, which I thought was, you know, that's a pretty good route. We get to go to Heidelberg again. We get to go to Darmstadt and Frankfurt, two cities that we've not been to yet. And I think that's pretty good. I think in this first part, because normally these are going to be like parts, they're not going to be a full long journey, because if it would be, it'd be like a 2-hour long video, and I don't really want to do that. So let's go into custom again. We're probably going to, in this video, I think we're going to probably do Mannheim to Heidelberg to Darmstadt and to Frankfurt. So today we're going to do to Frankfurt in this video, and then I think the next video, the part two video, will probably be from Frankfurt to Erfurt, because that'll be a, I would say, a fairly long drive. So if we go into new here, and if we go, if we name this route 220 and put down route 220, no express again, and then if we find Mannheim again down here, Mannheim, then we go to Heidelberg, then we go to Darmstadt, and then we go to Frankfurt. There is actually an alternate route, which is the night bus version of this route, that actually goes to Frankfurt Airport as well, but I'm not doing that because we already, in the previous episode, we were driving in the night, and I want to do this one from the early morning, and then eventually we'll do some night routes as well. We'll do some N routes, you know what I mean, so they will come. So we do, yeah, so we do Mannheim, Heidelberg, Darmstadt, Frankfurt, and then we do Erfurt. So that's going to be a very nice lengthy drive of 520 kilometers. Travel time of 7 hours 20 hours, so it'll be pretty lengthy. We'll give again about 3-4 minutes for checking time to keep it, you know, snappy, but not too long, but not too short, if you know what I mean. So if we save that up, I think that should be fine. Go all them down: Mannheim, Heidelberg, Darmstadt, Frankfurt, and Erfurt. In real life, I do believe it takes about 5 hours to do this journey, so I don't know how the game time works, in a sense, if it's throwing me out 7 hours, but it's sort of close enough. Cool little fact is, Route 220 actually is a very local route to me right now here in London, so it's kind of funny that I'm driving it. So if we go Route 20, next. I think we'll keep with the longer version coach for this drive again, and then we'll probably go back to the short wheel-based in the next one, I think. I want to drive the longer coach a little bit more. And if you noticed in my previous episode, a bit of lag, especially in the part 2 video, not lag, but FPS drops. It was because I was actually commented in the comments down saying that I actually had a stream on. I had a Twitch stream on in the background. That's why it was actually the FPS just dropped massively. I was wondering if it was the graphics or the settings or whatnot. It was purely the Twitch stream in the background, because when I recorded the first journey I did, part one, episode one and episode two, the FPS was perfect. So probably the Twitch stream that did that. So no Twitch stream today. Anyway, keep it again on realistic. Let's go hardcore here. Let's go a little bit into December now, because I want to kind of see it snow in a way, maybe. Oh no, let's do like January 10th, and that's okay. Time, I want to do it in the morning. I'm going to do the first service, which is at, I do believe, 6. It's at 6:50, I do believe. And it arrives at midday at Erfurt, if I'm saying that correctly. So if I go to 6:50, there we go. Keep again dynamic weather. Apparently there's no rain in the winter or whatnot, but okay, I accept that. And let's start the game. What if it's going to load up fast again like it did? But in the previous episode when I did this, I talked too much that it just loaded in and I didn't have to do any transition. I might just talk to you guys while this is transitioning. But it's a nice loading page, I guess. You know, very simple. It's not in your face with adverts like Train Sim. But you guys really are loving the series. I can see the response from that I'm getting. You guys really seem to be liking it. And this is kind of what I wanted to do, essentially, with Eurotruck or American Truck. But I don't know. I've been saying that, you know, I'm more of the kind of person that likes the logistics of, like, transporting passengers rather than, like, say, freight. And but I do like Eurotruck. I like American Truck. I like what they do. I like what you do in it. And I would have I'm still thinking about it, and I might do it. But I do have quite a lot on my plate to do in terms of YouTube with Train Sim, OMSI, this, like other things like Mini Metro, Bus Simulator 16, which is kind of coming to an end. And then there's other things, I have quite a lot on the plate of YouTube to do, in a way. I have quite a varied amount of stuff. I have, like, also BVE, which I'm doing, which kind of, I wanted to just do the tube lines, but now it's kind of gone into, like, people requesting me to do other things when I finish the tube lines, so, like, the New York subway, and, some other kind of open BV routes that you can get and whatnot. So that's going to probably be broader and take up a lot more time. So, but the thing is, I really would like to at some point do something with Eurotruck and American Truck, maybe more Eurotruck, and do something like I'm doing right here in Fernbus, because this is exactly like the kind of series I'd like to do in American Truck or Eurotruck. So, you know, right now, I do believe it is snowing. Oh God. I do believe it is snowing, guys. Oh my God, it is snowing. That is so pretty. And now that we have unlocked the actual map now, we can do this route. We can do the Stuttgart to Dresden, which I'll do at some point. Maybe the next route. Maybe if you guys want to see me do this one, the one that's on always advertised in the bus, that could be one. I've seen some, like, Munich to Frankfurt being tossed around and whatnot, some to Berlin and whatnot. It'd be cool if I had, like, a flashlight or something like that, because right now, I can't really see my bus. I think that's the thing I complained about in the previous, in a previous journey. Like, it's kind of a bit dark. I don't know if this is realistic or whatnot, but to me, it is kind of just a tad bit dark, if you know what I mean. Right, our bus is all good. Let's sit down. Let's take this off because I don't like it. Let's get things on, like the electrics and the ignition. There we go. Get the lights on. Could turn on the wipers as well. There we go. Maybe a slow wiper. What a slow wiper do? Tell me. That's a pretty slow wiper, isn't it? Now I'm gonna increase it by one more speed. Anyway, that is all done. Other than that, I'm gonna set up the lights and stuff for the passengers once I get to the station. I think that would be more wise to do. Be a bit more, like, you know, I guess realistic. I could turn them on now, but and all the destination board and whatnot. So I'll do that once we get to the station. Let me just quickly have a look on our map where we're actually going. And hopefully today, once we do a rest, we're going to definitely need a rest somewhere. Like, probably once we do the Frankfurt bit today in this video, we're probably going to need a rest at some point. So we definitely have two rest points along the way to Erfurt. So hopefully we can see what a rest point does, because we already checked what a petrol station does. So let me see here. So we're going to take a right, so just a right and a right, and then it will just guide me, which is good. Right, oh yes, forgot to close the door. There we go. Let the automatic gate open. Shouldn't be any traffic or whatnot in this kind of early morning, because we are leaving like at 6:50. It's very, oh God. There we go. Perfect. But again, if you guys have any suggestions for routes to do, definitely hit up the Flixbus website. and have a look at their routage, have a look at their routes and stuff that they do, and tell me what, because I think now I've unlocked most of the, well, I've unlocked all of the map to go to, but obviously I need to still get to these cities that I've not been to yet, because I can only start from a city that I've actually been to, but I can go to any, oh god, that was a really terrible steering there. Okay, we can go nice. Because I've so basically taking into account that of the cities that I've actually unlocked, so I've unlocked Munich, Regensburg, Nuremberg, Heilbronn, Heidelberg, Mannheim, and now in this journey we're going to be unlocking Darmstadt, Frankfurt, and Erfurt. So if you want to go and search on the Flixbus website, have a look at some of those cities that I just mentioned, see what routes go from there, and then, you know, we can, you know, we're venturing obviously up to the north, so this is going to be like the most northern part I've driven in this series, going up to Erfurt. It's not the most north, but it's, you know, it's pretty north, if you know what I mean. Right, is there anything coming from my left? No, that's all good. Now, I don't really feel any, because it's kind of snow slushy, I think. Let me turn down the wipers. I'm not really feeling any kind of, like, difference in driving mechanics, because obviously it's snowy, and it's slushy on the road, I can definitely see, but I can't see any kind of difference in the driving so far. Like, it feels very much the same. I don't know if that's something they're going to improve and make it a bit more, like, slippery or whatnot. There we go. Let's, turn off the engine and let's, set up things for our passengers. Wi-Fi on, the catering servers on, toilet on, reading lights on, PA we're going to put on once we get on the way. Put on the air conditioning, put it up to 23 degrees, as we find out that 23 degrees is the kind of nice temperature that everyone likes to be at. and then we can put on... Oh god, no, did I kill the electrics or something there? Okay, there, I don't know what that... Is that like the oil button or something? I really don't know. Right, I think that is all done. You can see outside. Bus looking very pretty. It does really look good, the graphics in terms of snow and whatnot, which is really nice. Let's turn down also the lights while we're here. Open both doors. There we go. Perfect. And I think that's essentially it. I think I've set up everything in terms of the bus. Let's go and greet our passengers. Let's open up the baggage compartments on both sides of the bus, because I'm authentic like that. Right, everyone put on their stuff. Let's get the Flixbus app logged in. Let's have a look at a bit of information on what we're dealing with today. We're picking up 12 passengers here from Mannheim, then going to Heidelberg and dropping off 6, picking up 11, then Darmstadt. We're picking up 3, dropping off 7, Frankfurt, picking up 15, dropping off 8, and then we're finally dropping off 22 people to Erfurt. That's quite big. I think that's the biggest, I think this is the biggest kind of, journey with people I think we've done so far. Right. Right, hello. Where are you bound from? Oh, yes, that's what I forgot. I forgot the destination display. If I press Z now. There we go. 220, Erfurt, Heidelberg, Darmstadt, Frankfurt, and Erfurt. Very nice. Now, will you come on my bus? Perfect. Hello. So you're going to Bonn Bushof. Romani. We don't go to Bonn. I'm very sorry. Hello there, you are Sean Sorter, you are on my list, and you are going to Heidelberg, welcome aboard. I wish this woman would go, the one that I denied her. Going to Heidelberg, Elisa Elisa Aliens, thank you very much. Welcome on board. Hello there, Leah Adam. Do we have a Leah Adam on the list? Yes, we do. And you're going today with us to Erfurt. Oh, wow. You're on the long haul with me. Hello there, Elia Hack. Going to Heidelberg. Welcome aboard. Paderborn. Oh, no. Sorry, Bo. We're not going anywhere near Paderborn. Very sorry to tell you. Look at the kids here. Look at the kids here. Heather Schumann. You are on our list and you go to Heidelberg. Welcome on board. You're going to Erfurt. Oh, another long journey. Passenger Enrico Pauli. You're on my list. Thank you very much. Welcome on board. Hello there. You're going to Heidelberg. Katrine Jacobs. Thank you very much. Express check-in. Thank you for joining us here with Flixbus. Had a kid standing on the on the bench. Oh, someone going to Frankfurt today. Evelina Echlert. Thank you very much. Welcome on board. And who's your boyfriend? Frankfurt. Karim Fiel. You're on my list. Welcome on board. I just drive with the next bus. Okay. Celine Doll. Going to Heidelberg. Welcome on board. Frankfurt. Miran Whitman. Whitman. Yes, welcome aboard, sir. And your twin is Frindley Kessler. Darmstadt, thank you very much. You are on, and thank you. And I do believe that's it. I think these two just will take another bus or something like that. So we've packed up everyone's suitcases, checked everyone in, everything is good. We can close the compartments and whatnot. There we go. Perfect. And we can close the back door here. There we go. Perfect. Look at that. Very nice. 220. All good. I wonder how many characters you can do. I think maybe 3 is the highest, or maybe 4. Because you could have like N102 or something like that. So we'll see in the future episodes when we do like longer routes and whatnot. Right. Let's get busy. Let's get busy. Oh, need to put it into neutral. There we go. Let's start ride. There we go. That's contacting control, by the way, which I forgot to do many times in the previous journey, but hey, I've done it now.
Hallo und herzlich willkommen bei Flixbus. Wir freuen uns, dass ihr an Bord seid und wir gemeinsam unser heutiges Reiseziel ansteuern. Bevor wir richtig in Fahrt kommen, hier ein paar Hinweise. Auch bei uns im Bus gilt die gesetzliche Anschnallpflicht. Bitte schnallt euch deshalb während der gesamten Fahrt an. In den Sitztaschen vor euch findet ihr unsere Bordkarte mit weiteren Sicherheitshinweisen und Infos Very nice. Zu unserem Snack- und Getränkeangebot. Eine Toilette befindet sich im hinteren Einstiegsbereich. Wer kostenlos surfen will, wählt sich einfach in unser WLAN-Netz ein. Unser Reisetipp fürs Internet? Schaut's doch mal auf unserer Facebook-Page vorbei. Unser Team freut sich riesig über eure Likes und Nachrichten. Sollte euer Akku zu Neige gehen? Kein Problem. Viele unserer Sitze sind mit Steckdosen ausgestattet und entsprechend gekennzeichnet. So könnt ihr euer Smartphone die gesamte Fahrt über nutzen. Wenn ihr eure nächste Fahrt auch gleich mobil buchen wollt, holt euch einfach unsere App und profitiert von exklusiven Online-Angeboten. Auf flixbus.de stehen täglich brandaktuell alle Infos und Städteverbindungen für euch bereit.
I definitely think on this journey we might have to top up on fuel, maybe, possibly. But these coach engines are really fuel efficient, so normally on like a journey like this you wouldn't really need to refuel during the journey.
We're glad to have you on board and that we can get you to your favorite destination today. Before we set off, we would like to share some information about the journey. The wearing of seatbelts is compulsory on board the bus. Therefore, please keep your seatbelt fastened throughout the entire journey. In the seat pocket in front of you, You will find our information card containing further safety instructions.
Goodbye, Mannheim.
Details of our snacks and beverages. There's a restroom located in the rear boarding area. If you would like to browse the internet free of charge, simply log on to our onboard Wi-Fi network. If your battery runs out, no problem. Many of our seats are equipped with power outlets, which are marked accordingly. If you would like to book your next journey while you're on the road, simply download our app onto your smartphone so you can take advantage of our many exclusive online discounts. For more information, simply visit flixbus.com or get in touch with us on Facebook. Of course, we're always striving to improve our service. Please use the questionnaire we send you by email to give us feedback about your journey. You can also use it to share your suggestions, ideas and requests. We are always ready to assist. And now, we can finally set off. Thank you for listening. We hope you have a relaxing journey and enjoy traveling with Flixbus.
I think it should be a very relaxing journey. Yeah, it will be. Well, this kind of first stint to Frankfurt is going to be very, like, quick drop-off kind of, you know, go and hit and run, essentially. And then between Frankfurt and Erfurt, it's going to be just basically nice, long driving, which I'm looking forward to. But I read somewhere, someone messaged me on Facebook with, like, a post, an article about how, like, Flixbus is just, like, buying out so many coach companies. Like, took over operations of like Megabus Europe, Stagecoach Megabus Europe, and they bought like Postbus, I think, which is like was the second biggest kind of coach company in Germany. So they're making money, Flixbus, definitely. Hopefully I don't have to put on the fog lights this time. Because we obviously, it's getting into the kind of day, this is like sunrise essentially, but it's not getting dark anymore, it can only get lighter. Now, we're supposed to go 50 here, so I'm just going to lower it down, because I feel that there are speed cameras when you actually exit out of city. Right. That's interesting, look at that bush there. And I smacked into a bush. Come on, get a bit of acceleration. I'm just like, I wish this accelerated better. I hope like some of the, I hope they're gonna implement some more like faster coaches, and whatnot. Because I don't think these are like the most powerful coaches out there. I feel there's gonna be ones that are gonna be a bit more powerful. Maybe these are the kind of like the standard coach that you'll see. But I've seen online there is like the double decker coach, which looks really cool, and I would love to see that in the game. Loads of people are saying that that's like another thing to see, the MAN double coach. There's all sorts of other coaches like Vanthall, there's other Volvo coaches, there's Plaxton. I don't know if Plaxton make any newer coaches or whatnot. Wow, this is crazy. Am I gonna have to actually see the, you know what I mean, the fog lights don't really do much, and I don't know why the lights at the front of the road are they're not extending anymore, which is a bit weird. So it doesn't really matter if I put on the fog lights, because the light won't extend that much further, which is a little bit annoying. Right. Coming up to a junction here, taking a left. How are our passengers doing today? Oh, look at this. Look at this mood lighting. Yes. Look at that. Fantastic. And I like how I'm in the wrong lane to go left. But it's fine. No problem. Perfect. Now I guess we're heading on the Autobahn back to Heidelberg, which we've already been to, as you know from our previous routage, 009. My grandparents are driving faster. Well, look, I had a red light to come up to here. I'm not going to drive like a maniac. And anyway, like, coaches don't go fast. They're not like fast transportation types. Like, yeah, sure, once they're on the motorway or the Autobahn, yeah, that's when they kind of, you know, open up the taps and go a bit. But, like, you know, coaches don't really go that fast. I think, I don't even know if certain coach companies limit their coaches to, like, they obviously have to be limited to 70. I'm sure they're not, like, they put like speed caps on the coaches and whatnot, so they kind of don't part. Like, this is in the UK I'm talking about. I'm assuming that they have like a 70 limit or whatnot. But I have, but weirdly I have seen like coaches, like National Express coaches, overtake me on the motorway, like at really fast speeds, and it kind of worries me a little bit. But I don't know. It's most of them drive below 70, but you have the odd one. I don't know, maybe that coach, that specific coach, was not tagged or capped as of yet. Oh no. Oh well. Couldn't slow down in time, there's snow on the ground. The safer thing to do was just continue. Right. I really, as I said in like the previous episode, I really love this ambience of kind of purple colours and this kind of purple haze. It's really beautiful. Because it like kind of spreads on the dash and whatnot, which is just, it's so nice. And no one's complaining about the temperature in the bus, which is really good. That's something, like, just keep it on 23. I think even if it's hot or cold, if you keep it on 23, no one complains. If you put it any lower, when it's even hot, people will complain. If you... yeah, if you put it above 23 when it's super, super cold, people complain. So, you know, 23 is the number. There we go. What is it? So, well, essentially between here, between Mannheim and Heidelberg, there's probably not going to be much motorway driving because, as you remember in the previous kind of journey, it was just kind of a little kind of short hop between the both little cities. But is Mannheim a little city? Like, I thought Mannheim was actually one of the kind of bigger cities, but I don't know. Because just going into Mannheim just had the kind of same layout that this and like Heilbronn and Nürnberg had, which I understand if those are kind of like the smaller cities, and then obviously you have the bigger cities that look different, like Munich, Frankfurt, Berlin. Those are going to look completely different. And hopefully today, once we get to Erfurt, whatever you want to call it, hopefully that's going to be really cool, because I've heard from the person that suggested me to do this route up to Erfurt is that because it's the home city of the designers and developers of this game, that they've detailed that city out a bit better than all the rest, because obviously that's where they live, obviously they know the place back to front, they should. But I'm hopeful. I'm hopeful that this line will prevail and be worthwhile. There we go, back in the cab. Got a green light, I like it. Now, I don't think we had many people that actually wanted to... Oh god, and get a flash speeding warning, nice. 50 is not enough. Like, what is 50? Is 50 like 30 miles per hour or something like that, I think? Or maybe it's less than 30 miles an hour? I'm not too sure. I'm always struggling when I convert miles per hour to kilometers per hour. Like, I'm just so fixed to miles per hour that when you do kilometers per hour, I just kind of... It kind of just doesn't gel well with my mind, because obviously I work with the miles per hour system here in the UK, while everywhere else pretty much uses kilometers per hour. I think the Americans actually use miles per hour in their cars. I think everywhere else uses kilometers per hour. Which, kilometers per hour is better, but I, you know, miles per hour is nice. It's interesting you having all these different units and conversions around the world. It's like a bit like temperature, like how, like, say some parts of the world use Fahrenheit compared to Celsius, which Celsius is good because it's using water as the it's using water as the actual subject of like what you're measuring temperature against. While Fahrenheit, I don't know what Fahrenheit uses. Fahrenheit uses just like, I'm not even too sure to be honest, but it uses something else, and that's what apparently the Americans thought was better. So they use that, and they don't bother to use a better one, I feel, because everyone knows what water is. Everyone knows should know the boiling point of water, which is 100 degrees. So it's just nicer to have that kind of thing, like you measure it off that. So I don't know. That's why, like, when I hear like Americans going, "Oh my God, it's 100 degrees outside," and I'm like, "What? Are you dying?" But no, it's Fahrenheit, because like 0 degrees Celsius in Fahrenheit is about, I think, 20 or 15 or something like that. Or 20 or 30 or so. I don't know. Like, I think a normal day, like say normal like 15, 20 degree days, like a 50 degree Fahrenheit day. I'm not too sure. I don't know my Fahrenheit. Don't know it at all. I think it's kind of confusing, and I don't know. But if you're grown up and you're brought up on Fahrenheit, then Celsius might look confusing to you, so I kind of understand both kind of points. Right, coming up here to Heidelberg Station. Pick up, oh wow, quite a lot of passengers I see here. Very nice. Right. Very nice. Doors open. I think I just slipped onto the curb a bit. You saw the coach there just kind of sliding down. Anyway. Wow. Okay. Welcome to Heidelberg. Let's get those open. Go around. Indicators on, as you can see there. Right, Flixbus is, the app is running, which is good, and it, oh wow, quite a lot of passengers check in today. So, was that only two passengers that actually we dropped off? Wow, okay. Darmstadt, you are Azad Angler. Welcome aboard, sir. Darmstadt, Vince Bud, hello, welcome on board. Louisa Cords, yes, and you're going to Darmstadt. Everyone's going to Darmstadt from here. Mario Schreiber, hello, and you go, oh, going to Erfurt, like it, long journey. Larissa Juncker, Frankfurt, Juncker, yes, you're on here, welcome on board. Why is your bag still, why are you still holding your bag? It's not in the compartment or whatever. Elise Aldrich, Frankfurt. Alice Aldrich, thank you very much. You're here on the list. Welcome. Frankfurt Airport. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm very, very sorry. If this was the night bus, you would definitely be able to get on, but sorry. Okay, this passenger doesn't work. Darmstadt, Termina Glasser. Thank you very much. Welcome aboard. No one's facing me, so I don't know who I'm talking to. But this is Mary Hartman. We do have a Mary Hartman. She's going to Darmstadt, which is all good. Welcome aboard. You are Mary. Okay. Welcome aboard, sir. Ian Road. Yes, we do have you today. You're traveling with us to Frankfurt. Very nice. Soraya Schwartz, Erfurt again, very nice, long journey person. You are on our list, welcome on board. You are Sven Hiller, we have a Sven Hiller, which is good. And you're going with us today to Darmstadt, very nice, welcome aboard. And you, not going to do anything, and are you going to... No, I think this is just a passenger that's just standing here because they want to stand. And I do believe that is it. I think we've checked in everything we need to do. We don't have anything to do left. That's all very nice. Good, we've done Heidelberg. Let's get the compartments and stuff closed. Or maybe it's because I didn't open this. Or not. I don't know. We'll leave them. We've done everything on our checklist, so there we go. Oh, look at those animations, and the sounds are so good.
They bring joy to my ears. Right, bye bye rejects. I'm getting a nice little packed bus here. I like it. Oh, I didn't put the screen on. I didn't put the screen on. That's something. Where's the screen? There we go. Nice, he does it.
Hallo und herzlich willkommen bei Flixbus. Wir freuen uns, dass ihr an Bord seid und wir gemeinsam unser heutiges Reiseziel ansteuern. Bevor wir richtig in Fahrt kommen, hier ein paar Hinweise. Auch bei uns im Bus gilt die gesetzliche Anschnallpflicht. Bitte schnallt euch deshalb während der
gesamten AC too cold.
In den Sitztaschen vor euch findet ihr unsere Bordkarte.
It's the first time I've had that.
Hinweisen und Infos zu unserem Snack- und Getränkeangebot. Eine Toilette befindet sich im hinteren Einstiegsbereich. Wer kostenlos surfen will, wählt sich einfach in unser WLAN-Netz ein.
I do believe the coffee machine is somewhere down here near the opposite the toilet, I do believe. I've seen a video online of like how it looks like, it's pretty cool, it's neatly tucked away.
Euer Akku zu Neige gehen, kein Problem. Viele unserer Sitze sind mit Steckdosen ausgestattet und entsprechend gekennzeichnet. So könnt ihr euer Smartphone die gesamte Fahrt über nutzen. Wenn ihr eure nächste Fahrt auch gleich mobil buchen wollt,
there we go, nicely does it, good turn. And now the AC is too hot, would you believe that?
Auf flixbus.de stehen täglich brandaktuell alle Infos.
How do you go from like just a few degrees up saying, oh yeah, that's just too hot for me? I'll change it when we get to like a stop longer than 2 seconds.
Wir danken für eure Aufmerksamkeit und wünschen eine entspannte Fahrt und viel Spaß an Bord bei Flixbus. Hello and welcome to Flixbus. We're glad to have you on board and that we can get you to your favorite destination today. Before we set off, we would like to share some information about
that should be good. If it's not, then these people are picky. Yeah, okay, these people are picky.
Throughout the entire journey. In the seat pocket
so,
in front of you,
okay.
Information card containing further safety instructions and details of our snacks.
Apparently, they only wanted it above. They only wanted it increased by half a degree. That's the precise accuracy they want.
Simply log on to our onboard Wi-Fi network. If your battery runs out, no problem. Many of our seats are equipped with power outlets, which are marked accordingly. If you would like to book your next journey while you're on the road, simply download our app onto your smartphone so you can take advantage of our many exclusive online discounts. For more information, simply visit flixbus.com.
Oh, shut up with the AC's too hot, please.
Of course,
someone said it was too cold before. If I put it down to 23, someone's going to complain that it's too cold.
We send you by email to give us feedback about your journey.
People are so picky these days.
Share your suggestions, ideas and requests. We are always ready to assist. And now, we can finally set off. Thank you for listening. We hope you have a relaxing journey and enjoy traveling with Flixbus.
And please don't complain about the bloody temperature if it's only half a degree up from what you've already complained what was too cold. Jesus. And I'm going to get marked down for that because, you know, these passengers are a bit incompetent, you know, when it comes to knowing what their body temperature likes. Jesus. So, I'm going to lower it down now to 22.5 and watch how someone goes and complains, hey, the AC's too cold. Just watch. Because I'm going to be too... It's snowing, for God's sakes, outside. How could you be hot? I mean, yeah, how can you be hot? You should be cold. Look at this beautiful winter wonderland we're in. You know, just people complaining about just the most little things. A half a degree. Crazy. Well, again, just watch. Someone's going to complain about it being too cold and I'm going to get triggered. It's all good. Right, so I don't think we're on the autobahn or whatever. I think this is like some sort of like dual carriageway kind of thing to the motorway. So I'm just going to get up a little bit more to speed. And let's maybe put on the cruise control. Yeah, let's get it on. This is a nice speed to maintain. I'm good with this. Good to maintain it in the lane. I'm relaxed. We have a good journey upon us. But this beautiful snow. The snow looks fantastic, and the tracks and stuff that have been left in the roads are just really, really nice. Very good. As I was talking about, like, what buses they could add to this game, one of the ones people I've been seeing suggesting and whatnot and really want to see is the double-decker coach. That'd be really cool, because obviously you can walk around in coaches. Imagine, like, walking around on the lower deck, then walking around on the top deck, I don't know. You know, one thing which would have been really cool is maybe when you finish your shift, you might have to clear up some of, like, I don't know if the coach drivers actually do this in real life, they have to, like, clear up the coach before the next shift or whatnot. So it would have been cool maybe to see something like that, where I actually have to go around, maybe clear up some of the litter that gets spilt around, because I'm pretty sure at the end of a coach journey, even though you would say, oh, can you clear up any litter that you might have dropped and whatnot. Oh, I'm speeding. We went to 50 just there outside the petrol station. Oh, that's really annoying, and now I have to kind of pick up the speed again to get back onto the cruise control. There we go. But yeah, like, that would be a cool feature. Like, I finish my last job at Erfurt, and then I go around and I see there's a few little cups, and maybe there's a little, like, few chewing gum wrappers and whatnot, and I just clear out. And that would add a little bit of, you know, that kind of coach driver life, I would suppose. You know. Well, like, you know, because there's catering service available on board, it'd be interesting to, you know, maybe get maybe have people walk up and go and get a coffee or something, and then actually see, like, some income that will, like, come from it, and you'd maybe get a display, maybe a notification saying, oh, someone's bought a coffee or something like that, you know. I don't know if that would be something cool to have. I don't know. And maybe, I don't know, on the Flixbus app thing, I could maybe see how many people have, or maybe that would be a good place to actually have it, like, see how many people have maybe bought, like, a coffee or something, or, like, any of the confessions, and then maybe see how many people have connected up to the Wi-Fi network, and then, I don't know, maybe I'm going a little bit too much, maybe that's not what actual Flixbus drivers actually can see with their Flixbus app or whatever, but, I don't know. Or maybe, like, at the end of the ship, maybe check how much the coffee machine or something has made. Oh, that was heartbreaking. I'm not gonna lie, that was really, really heartbreaking. But we managed it. You can see there, taking a left to Darmstadt on the 426. Guessing that's the 426 Autobahn. If I had to guess. Oh, you're squeezing there rather. Look at that. Look at this guy. Wait for me to go. You should have just waited. You just, like, scraped past me. I'll have my lawyers contacting you, sir. Right. It's pretty much daytime now. I might slowly but surely turn off the lights. Maybe once we get to Darmstadt. I'll turn off the lights. For now, I'll keep them on, because it's probably about maybe, I don't know what time it is, maybe coming up to 7? I can't see actually the time on that little green LCD display on the left of the steering wheel. Oh, we have to only go 70 here, damn. Go a little bit too fast here. But look at this, cars can go past 70. Is it maybe like a speed limit on whatever, on coaches and buses or whatnot? That's the only kind of plausible explanation I can see. Someone was telling me actually, like in the previous episodes when I was driving and I was seeing the signs, the warning signs of, like, lowering speed to, like, say from 130 to 120 and whatnot, and why I was still getting speeding kind of notifications even though I was driving at, like, what it was telling me. Apparently that buses can only, and coaches can only on the Autobahn only go up to 100. So that's why. So I can never venture beyond 100. Oh wow, look at that. They could easily add coaches to They could easily add coaches to this game if they really wanted to. They have the, like, sport, like, they look, that's like a cool little freight port or whatever. They could easily do it. And then have coaches and trucks. It'd be cool. And then maybe one day a multiplayer mod will be added to this. I don't know if multiplayer is like a thing that they, that TML themselves want to do or add to the game themselves. But it would be cool to see if, like, say the guys that did the multiplayer mod for, that did it for Euro Truck and American Truck to kind of, maybe, I don't know if it'll be harder for them to do because obviously this is a completely different thing, but maybe, might be possible. It's open world, it's, you know, we can dream is what I'm just basically saying. Very quiet today, I think, yeah, we are in, are we in Darmstadt already? Not too sure, you know. I'm trying to keep the speed very low. Cause I don't wanna break it. But it's nice, there's no actual traffic lights here, which is super cool. I agree with no traffic lights. Oh god. Very nice. Oh, and then the first traffic light as soon as I turn and I say there's no traffic lights. And it goes green. Nice. Didn't even need to put on the parking brake. Right. Is our... Oh, a bus stop is just up there ahead. We're just doing a loop around. Okay, that's cool. I like that. I appreciate that. And this city already looks very different. Does not look at all to the layout that I was seeing in the previous cities that I've been to since Nuremberg. There we go. Fantastic. Donna Pizza. Mm-hmm. We're quiet this morning. I guess it's quiet. The AI would be quiet because, like, it's the morning. What do you expect? It's like just before 7 o'clock. But I guess it will pick up in rush hour, like near 8 o'clock-ish, I suppose. Right. Thank you. And our station's coming up. Very different station. Very kind of smaller one. Similar to the one at Regensburg, actually. There we go. Perfect. Right. Time to... Actually, I won't open these. Because it... Oh, actually, there's quite a lot of people that want to get stuff out. I'll just open this one. Save us a bit of time. Right, here at Darmstadt. Holy. Lol, destructible environments. Did I do that or did the passenger do that? I'm really not sure, actually. So let's just have a look here. We're picking up 3 people here. Oh, so it's not really that much. So we're picking up Anglo, De Milan, Cop, and Mirek Putz. Okay, that's cool. I can... That's nice. But we've vandalized a bit here, which is a bit tragic. Anyway, who is coming on board? You are not. Hello there, Milan Cop. Express check-in, you're on our list. Thank you very much. Welcome on board. And you are Anglo Der. Thank you very much. You're going with us to Erfurt. Very well. And Frankfurt. Milan Putz. Welcome, welcome. Cool, everyone on. All good. Is that a train station there, I would suppose, or some sort of expo center? I'm not too sure. That's pretty cool, though. Right. I can close it from there if I want to. Is everyone okay? Everyone doing good? Everyone had a coffee and whatnot? Very nice. Get the PA on again.
Hallo und herzlich willkommen bei Flixbus. Wir freuen uns, dass ihr an Bord seid und wir gemeinsam unser heutiges Reiseziel ansteuern. Bevor wir richtig in Fahrt kommen, hier ein paar Hinweise. Auch bei uns im Bus gilt die gesetzliche Anschnallpflicht. Bitte schnallt euch deshalb während der gesamten Fahrt an. In den Sitztaschen vor euch findet ihr unsere Bordkarte mit weiteren Sicherheitshinweisen und Infos zu unserem Snack.
Tell me if you guys would like me to keep doing this PA, because if you don't, then I won't do it every stop. But I think it's kind of simulates, you know, I don't even know if they put the PA on at every single stop, but you guys, like, when I missed one PA out, you guys are like, where's the PA? So I'll do it just to simulate it.
Viele unserer Sitze sind mit Steckdosen ausgestattet und entsprechend gekennzeichnet. So könnt ihr
das Fahrzeug
die gesamte Fahrt übernutzen. Wenn ihr eure nächste Fahrt auch gleich mobil buchen wollt, holt euch einfach unsere App und profitiert von exklusiven Online-Angeboten. Auf flixbus.de stehen täglich und aktuell alle Infos und Städteverbindungen für euch bereit. Natürlich wollen wir unseren Service ständig weiter verbessern. Für Feedback zu eurer Fahrt nutzt bitte den Fragebogen, den wir euch
I think we're doing alright with fuel as well.
Wir danken für eure Aufmerksamkeit und wünschen eine entspannte Fahrt und viel Spaß an Bord bei Flixbus. Hello and welcome to Flixbus. We're glad to have you on board and that we can get you to
I'm excited now because we're going oh god, I need to take a
Before we set off, we would like to share some information about the journey. The wearing of seatbelts is compulsory on board the bus. Therefore, please keep your seatbelts.
I'm also going to turn off the full beams now and go down to lower beams. Well, you know what, actually, let's turn off the lights fully. Let's have the dashboard bare.
There's a restroom located in the rear boarding area.
Right, here we go. Quick waterbound driving up to Frankfurt.
Log on to our onboard Wi-Fi network. If your battery runs out, no problem. Many of our seats are equipped with power outlets, which are marked accordingly. If you would like to book your next journey while you're on the road, simply download our app onto your smartphone so you can take advantage of our many exclusive online discounts. For more information, simply visit flixbus.com or get in touch with us on Facebook. Of course, we're always striving to improve our service. Please
just activated the cruise control
by email to give us feedback about your journey. You can also use it to share your suggestions, ideas and requests. We are always ready to assist. And now we can finally set off. Thank you for listening. We hope you have a relaxing journey and enjoy traveling with Flixbus.
I love how we've just set off, but essentially we're here at Frankfurt already. So the PA took basically the journey to get here, essentially, which is kind of funny in my opinion. But we're here. Frankfurt looks really good. I think Frankfurt's going to be a really nice, detailed big city to go into because I can already see like really unique buildings and stuff coming up in it, which look really good. And it has an airport as well, so that's pretty cool as well. Can I merge here? Thank you. Thank you, traffic. Much appreciated. Oh, going a little off-road. But we're essentially here at Frankfurt, which is good. Right. Can I merge? Thank you very much. All good. No crashes today, which is pretty good. The AI is behaving a lot better with the update, it stopping at red lights. I can definitely tell a huge difference when I'm in the cities. But generally, it's been pretty good. No crashes, which is very good. Fast. Let's hopefully keep it that way. Let's keep it clean for the rest of the series, which I doubt it will continue. Ooh. Quite a turn here. Ooh, almost, but close, but not close enough. There we go. Whoa, what was that? Just a splat of water or snow on the windscreen, Jesus. Let's get the wipers on full. Yeah, I think it's just started snowing again. Or technically raining as well, but even though raining is disabled during winter. Right, I'm going to have to merge in here. Let's get... I can't see... Oh, now I can see stuff. There we go. I hope I'm in the right lane to actually go off here into Frankfurt. No, I'm not. I need to be on the the outer inner lane. There we go. Good. So, I do believe we're here. It's very misty as well here in Frankfurt. Slow over drive. Wait, what? I don't know, these passenger comments. It'd be better if they could actually say what this, you know, what it's just showing me in the text. I would appreciate it a lot more if they were actually telling me it with a voice. Because in the text, it's like, okay, but a voice, it would be a bit more funnier, you know what I mean? Like a Nompsey. Right, let's get into this lane. Perfect. And what's that to Wurzburg? Wurzburg, I don't know. We'll get there eventually. Go around and do all the cities, as I said, in this series, essentially. I think by the time there's like a proper big update for this game in terms of like maybe adding a bus or something or more cities, by then I'll probably get through all of the cities and whatnot. So there's still like there's a lot to do in terms of getting around and actually looking at places that I've not been to. That's like the first thing to do in this series, go around, have a look at every city. Right, Frankfurt. I wonder if there's trams lurking around, would be really cool to see. I doubt it though, but again, we can dream. Oof, that was close. But this city does look different. Frankfurt obviously being one of the major cities, like what is the kind of like major cities? Like as I was saying in like previous episodes, what are the major cities of this of Germany? It's Berlin, Frankfurt, Munich, Dusseldorf, Cologne. Those are kind of the big ones, the main big ones. Not too sure. It's like is it basically the ones that have like a metro? Like I think like a big city generally tends to have a metro service, if you know what I mean. Some don't. Like say Birmingham. Birmingham in the UK doesn't have a metro system, but it's like a really, really big city. Sheffield is a big city in the UK, but doesn't have a metro system, has a tram system. All good. And I can't wait till like we see other AI coaches as well on the routes as well. It'd be cool, just instead of just, you know, me being myself and the only, like I can see trucks and lorries and stuff, and in your truck you're not driving by yourself, there's other lorries and trucks doing their kind of thing, but in this game so far there's only me doing coach stuff while everyone else is, you know, everything else is just AI cars or AI lorries but no buses, which it's like I'm the only green Flixbus on the whole map right now. Right, let's see how we're doing this. Anyone gonna be kind? The police is not gonna be kind. Am I gonna make this? Yes, I am. Good turning circle. Obviously, it has the. I do believe the wheels do turn. I did say in the previous episode if I was gonna see if the back axles actually turn. Yes, they do turn, which is pretty cool. Oh, it does look really nice with all this snow around. It does. Getting Christmassy vibe. It's like 100 and something days till Christmas, so we're just getting that early hype in there. Well, that's a pretty tall red building, isn't it? If I beep at the police car, do they like flash me? No, obviously they don't. Is it illegal to like beep at the police? I don't know. Well, I just did it, so you know. Where is this station? It feels like, well, it really feels big, the city. Definitely does. Maybe we're going to like, I think it's the central train station we're going to. Which I think is half Bahnhof. So, you know, going to a big train station, which I'm very eager to see. Maybe I can recognize some stuff from the Just Trains Frankfurt Metro. I doubt it though, because I think I just bumped him. But he's a nice policeman. He knows he can forgive. So if I turn my wheels, actually, you can see that the back axle turns, which is pretty cool. Ooh. Do a bit of exterior driving. Even though it's not my best forte. Not too bad. Oh. And we go back. Not too bad. But it's improving, it's improving. I'm definitely not going to do any... Actually, I need to go back into the interior to see if the traffic light's changed. Which it has, which is good for me. Right. This is looking very nice. And I do believe this is the main station here now. And our coach station's right here now to the right, which is very nice. And that should conclude our first part of doing... oh my god, I really need to fix this glitchy exterior camera, I have to say, because it just loves to glitch out like that. It just zooms in randomly. But this concludes the first part of our journey on Route 220, going from Mannheim to Erfurt via Heidelberg and Darmstadt, and now in our current station, Frankfurt. So let's open up the doors. Turn off the engine. Having got a little bit of a longer stop here at Frankfurt. Let's get the luggage compartments open. There we go. We're here in Frankfurt. We have a lot of people to check in for the next part, where we basically do the long drive. We do the long drive from here, from Frankfurt up to Erfurt, which is all pure driving. We're probably going to have to use a rest area at some point, which would be cool, and maybe even a petrol station, possibly. I don't know, I'm not too sure. We'll see what happens in the next part, but this part's been long enough. It's been an hour and a bit, but, you know, it's you know, these are journeys we're going to be doing. It's long, it's 1 to 10 scale, so, you know, it's going to be sort of longish. So, but I hope you guys enjoy this first part, driving on the real-life Flixbus route, 220. We're going from, again, Mannheim to Erfurt. We did the first part going from Mannheim to Frankfurt via Heidelberg and Frankfurt, which we're currently at. We're going to continue, and Darmstadt, what about that? We're going to continue in the next part up to Erfurt all the way. Hope you guys can join me for that when that comes out. The shoutouts again in this video go to ComputerFace79 and Luke Maidstone. That's again ComputerFace79 and Luke Maidstone. Their links and stuff will be down below. Please do show them some love. And I'll see you guys in the next part. Bye. We ain't never-